From Emmy-nominated turns on American Horror Story and This Is Us to stealing scenes alongside Meryl Streep, Denis O'Hare is one of our favorite actors to watch.
Indeed. He's currently starring in 3 movies, including The Parting Glass, a personal project that also marks his screenwriting debut. Take a look.
He says, I can't actually have the note, but he says maybe he can read some of it to me.
No, Dad, this doesn't surprise me. From the minute you called, I knew what this was.
Until I know, I don't want to go around assuming anything.
I think it's pretty obvious. She...
No, no, no.
And Denis joins us now. Welcome back.
Thank you for having me. Happy anniversary, by the way. 10 years.
Thank you so much. We both love this movie. It was so moving. But for you, it is autobiographical, for those who don't know, and you basically play yourself.
Yeah.
And what made you want to write this story about your sister's suicide?
You know, I started out as sort of therapy. Mm. I started writing it quickly after it happened. I wrote an email to a lot of my friends to describe the weekend that this actually portrays, which is my family gathering to go and clean out my sister's apartment because she was no longer alive. And I wrote an email, which was a long email, which became like a story. And several people said to me, wow, what a powerful story. That's like a movie. I started writing the screenplay as therapy just to get it out. And I wrote it out sort of in a rush and then spent some years with Stephen Moyer perfecting the screenplay. I wanted to honor her.
Yeah.
She was a great person. Suicide is a difficult topic to talk about. What happens in suicide is that we, the survivors, are left with no one to talk to.
Yeah.
Because no one knows how to talk about it. It's taboo.
Yeah.
No one knows what to do. People tend to blame you in a weird way.
Yeah.
That you, why didn't you do something? Why didn't you keep her alive? If it were my sister, I would have, called her more, been... You know, the truth of the matter is, for my sister's case, she was somebody who found it painful to be alive.
Yeah.
And she struggled for 44 years, and she had an amazing life in some of that time, but ultimately she chose to do this. And the movie talks about, what do we do with that?
Yeah.
How do you deal with the grief? You get no answers, you get no closure, you can't talk to them.
Yeah.
You get no preparation, you don't get to have you don't even get to say goodbye.
Yeah.
That's the hardest thing, and you that's really what I wanted to share.
You just showed us a side of suicide that we don't often get to see.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, the casting in this was amazing too.
Yeah.
You have such an incredible cast. Ed Asner, Melissa Leo, Cynthia Nixon.
Risa Fans.
Yeah.
Anna Paquin.
Yeah. You go about casting basically your family,
which is like a little mini True Blood.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. You know, Stephen Moyer and I...
Who directed it.
And he wanted to direct it. He did an amazing job on it. And we started putting together a dream cast. Cynthia said yes early on, which was amazing. Melissa Leo joined us pretty quickly, and that's amazing. Then it kind of snowballs. And Risa Fans is an old friend of Stephen's from England, and he joined. And Anna had to because she was married to Stephen.
Yeah, right?
You have to do
this. No choice.
And Ed Asner, we were so delighted to get. Ed Asner is an amazing treasure.
He's
a national treasure.
He is.
I think his work in this is extraordinary. I'm so happy that the audience get to see the performance he gives. He's funny, he's touching, he's irascible as he only can be.
Yeah.
But everyone has this great range in this movie.
Yeah.
Everyone gets their moment to shine, and I'm so happy for that.
So well done. Yeah. Okay, we got to talk about the Goldfinch.
Yeah.
What's it like playing a character from a book? That's so popular.
Yeah.
You know, I had practiced because I did True Blood, and those fans are rabid. You know, True Blood fans don't want to stray. And I learned early on that you have to be true to the material while being free enough to interpret it on your own.
Yeah.
And so with the Goldfinch, I love this character, Lucius Reeves, and I think I tried to do him justice, but I also have my own ideas about it.
Yeah.
With John Crowley and I talked about, you know, it's a movie that's a great evocation of the book. You can't do a 780 pages, you know.
Yeah.
How do you do that?
Yeah.
So they found a brilliant way to condense the story down to the stuff that you have to have.
Yeah.
I think everyone is terrific in the movie. I'm excited for people to see it.
And it's out this weekend, right?
I think it's out now. Yeah.
Well, you got to come back and talk about Big Lies and all that kind of stuff.
And Meryl Streep.
I know.
Yes.
All right. Well, The Parting Glass is available on digital now, and follow Denis on social media to keep up with all of his projects. Great to have you here.
Thank you very much.
Love you on The Good Fight as the judge.
Thank you.
So good.